Hey.
What I love
favorite.
It.
Oh my
Kay,
gosh.
Who wants to kick it off? Who wants to go first?
Grace.
Let's hear it.
All right. It's me. Okay.
So you pick one of many.
Yeah.
If I have a question about one you've said in the past and I want more details, I'll go for that.
Okay. Oh my God, I love that. Okay. Cool. That was my thought. Thank you.
Cool.
Okay. So this. Oh my God, I can't believe it. It's almost too soon to tell this story, but anyway, so it's very recent. So a couple months ago, a professional athlete hit me up
on
Instagram DMs. Actually, he met one of my friends, and then she, because I'm single and she's not. So anyway, so we got set up. He wanted to fly me out, and I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I was like,
yeah.
I was just in that mindset. Like, I've never done anything crazy like that. I'm like, this is like the perfect time. I was like, why not? I don't know. I have a job. I can just leave. So anyway, so I ended up flying to New York City. He is foreign. So he said that he like couldn't pay for anything up front, which that was a rookie mistake. Number
one. Oh God.
Red flag. We got a red flag.
That might be a deal breaker, but yeah, for sure.
Oh my gosh. Now my lesson learned, like I'm never going to do that ever again. But anyway, so I flew out to New York City. It was total spur of the moment. It was like a 16-hour trip. It was like the most expensive flight ever because it was like last minute. Anyway, I dropped like $3,000 on this.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. So,
and he was a professional athlete?
Yes.
And you dropped $3,000?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. All right. All right.
Yeah, we are accepting it as it is.
All right.
Okay. So anyway, back to the story. So flew out to New York City. It was like 2 a.m. by the time I got there. I cried a lot in the cab. I forgot about that. The Uber ended up being like $100 because she couldn't find me. And then I was bawling because I was so confused. And I like didn't really even want to be there anymore. And I was like, this is the worst. Anyway, so it was a learning experience. But anyway, flew there. Saw him for like 15 minutes.
15 minutes?
Mm-hmm. And he's like, you know what? He's like, I gotta go to bed. Like, I'll see you
and
in the morning.
And then
nothing.
Is that what it was?
Girl.
Can I ask? Yeah? Okay.
It was bad.
Horrifying.
Yeah. Bad.
Horrifying.
Not good.
We're not going to even.
Disgusting.
No. No.
Yeah, it was bad.
Oh, no.
I mean, it wasn't like bad. I mean, it was like a hookup, right? Like, I mean, like it was like whatever.
But
it was just,
there.
He was like 30 seconds. I was like, this is awesome. Cool. Okay. Anyway, so whatever. So I flew home, like didn't really hear from him, but also
so you
did
went
hear
there,
from him.
You went there and saw him for 15 minutes.
And the hotel was
Shut
like $1 million
up.
Dollars. Like, it was like the nicest place I've ever stayed. Yeah. And I was like, all right, cool. Like, he's paying for it. Like, I was under the impression, like, he was really
God.
Nice.
So
you're
sorry.
Telling me he told you to come out.
Yeah.
And he didn't pay for anything?
Nothing. No.
Because it was last minute?
No. And then.
How did this happen?
Girl, get this. So,
two weeks ago.
So I was like, okay, he's going to do it. Like, whatever. Like, he just can't. Like, all his money's in a foreign country, whatever. Like, he needs to give me cash. I don't know. I was just trying to make excuses because I was like, I just see the good in everybody.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
it was,
no, you were
oh
being
my God.
Kind.
Anyway, so 2 weeks ago, I found out that he is engaged. He posted a TikTok. Yeah. And I was like, oh. And then I was blocked all of a sudden on everything. And, like, I was like, okay, ooh, wow. So, anyway, so then I kind of, like, made a TikTok back. Like, I just duetted with him. Which
oh,
I,
you did? You're
I deleted
ballsy.
It. No, I deleted it, but not before his fiance saw it, which I was kind of happy
Good.
About. I was
yeah.
like, okay, no, but get this, though. Oh, my gosh. So she literally, like, she DM'd me. She was like, hey, like, that's harassment on me. Like, you're making me look bad, and you,
dude,
you'll be hearing from my lawyer.
Your
I'm like,
fiance
wait, what?
Makes you look bad.
I sent her all the screenshots, because first she was just like, what happened? She's like, I want to know, like, well, like, what happened? Like, why, what's going on? Mm-hmm. So I told her, I sent her every single screenshot I have of all of our conversations, all of the bills or all the receipts. You know, I sent her the receipts. Mm-hmm. And she read it all, and she goes, I'm getting married. This is my wedding. No one's going to ruin it. You will be hearing from my lawyers.
Are you kidding?
Oh, which I'm not scared Atlanta. Of at all. But like,
no,
I was like, so she didn't even care. She's yeah. So
anyway, she knows that it's happening.
And I'm not
it's
getting it back.
Gonna...
I've just accepted it. Yeah, I guess. And get this. Okay. Because I posted that TikTok, another girl who's from Brookings, South Dakota, of all places. I'm from South Dakota. Anyway, she was like, hey, like, I saw your video, like,
same.
He did, like, the same thing, except, but
okay.
She never ended up flying anywhere. ever. So like it didn't.
Not raising money.
He's like reaching out to the Midwest, thinking nothing will get back to the fiance.
Like, oh, bro. Oh, oh. Wow. And I told him that because he was like being weird and ghosty. Yeah. And I was like, maybe that's just like professional athletes do. I don't know. I've never messed around with it, like anything like that before. Yeah, I don't know. He just got weird.
Dude,
got
that's
weird.
Brutal.
It got weird. I know. And I don't know.
The sad thing is a lot of people can probably relate to exactly what you're talking about.
Totally, totally. And I never thought I'd ever find myself in that situation, but I, whatever. Yeah. I mean, I'm lucky. Like, I have a good job. Like, I'm not, like, is it ideal? No, but, like...
And knowing, okay. And like what I know about you is like you're so free spirited and you're like, you know what? I'm going to give it a go. Like maybe this is my husband. I'm going to go to New York and meet this guy. And
I like
and
to romanticize
just,
everything.
Yeah. I mean, it's better to live in on a positive, optimistic note than it is 100%. To just think the bad in everyone. So.
I have zero regrets. I honestly, you guys, like not to get like real, but like I needed that. I think. Like I feel like all the best highs come from the lowest lows. And
I always say that too.
Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm. Look at mm-hmm. us. It's like I listen to your podcast.
So weird.
I don't know. I think I needed that with men. And now there's been like a shift.
Yay.